International Immigrant Center in Boston. That's a center that is representing many of the families who may be forced to leave the country due to this change. Mr. Marino, thanks for helping us understand this tonight. Thanks for giving some of your time.
Thanks for having me here, Rachel. I really appreciate it.
So let me just ask first if I explain this accurately. It's almost hard to believe that this really is what they're doing.
Yeah, it's unfathomable. I think you did a good job explaining it. This is a program that's existed on the assumption that there was some humanity left in the government, that if a child falls ill while you're here, that rather than cowering over a sick child in the shadows, that you would come forward and explain to the government what was going on, and that there would be some humanity there, that like a child is sick, is in a hospital bed, and I know that we're supposed to be leaving, but we just can't, that the government would allow people to stay for that reason. It just seems ridiculous that it's completely unfathomable that they wouldn't.
One of the unfathomable things when you try to put yourself in the shoes of these parents is the timeline here. I mean, they're being told get out in 33 days. They've started receiving these letters with no warning over the past few days. I mean, do these families have any chance to appeal? Do they have any recourse that's being offered to them?
No, I mean, essentially what the government is saying is that this is a program that was always just sort of at our discretion. And that's true on individual, on a case-by-case basis. But they're saying that they have the power to just eliminate it altogether, which is what they've done, and that there is no appeal. I don't know why they came up with 33 days. Hmm. They're telling these people that they need to leave on their own. I don't know how they expect parents to pull their children from hospital beds, disconnect them from life-saving treatment, and go somewhere where they know the child's going to die. But that's what they're telling them to do, and if they don't, they're going to drag them through deportation proceedings.
In terms of the next steps here, I mean, obviously, people who can get lawyers and try to fight this and try to find some way to argue with the government here are going to do so. Do you know if there are plans to try to challenge this on a policy basis to try to stop the Trump administration from making this wholesale change?
Yeah, so there's definitely an attempt. We've tried reaching out. Of course, we had no notice of this either, which is really problematic. There was no announcement that this program was ending. We were filing applications up until the week before we started getting the notices. There was no notice to the immigration attorneys, to the individuals. There was no hint that this was coming. It's still unclear what's going to happen to people already in the program. But there's also an effort to come up with a legal strategy to challenge this in the courts, because it's just so egregious, and the way they did it was so egregious, and the exercise of prosecutorial discretion is a fundamental part of our legal system. It always has been. And for the administration to just say it's gone overnight is unbelievable.